Yes, I think the Honourable Nick Garan is on urgent parliamentary business now. Can't hear me speak. Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I'm sure he is listening, absolutely. Firstly, I would like to thank... it's great to get the... Oh, here is the Honourable Member who was trying to goad me into speaking. Well, unfortunately, I couldn't speak on the last report because it was noted, but we're on to a new report now. So I rise to speak on the Standing Committee on Estimates and Financial Operations, report number 78. Firstly, thank the Honourable Martin Pritchard for his contribution. That was very interesting. And I'd also like to thank the members on the committee. I will note, since coming into this parliament, that this committee does seem to be one of the harder working ones. I know the Honourable Alana Clossy, around estimates time with her whole committee, the Honourable Diane Evers, the Honourable Aaron Stonehouse, the Honourable Bjorn Sidmer, and the Honourable Colin Ticknell are flat out. And it's quite a busy period. And the budget processes that I've gone through since being in Parliament have been quite a learning experience, not coming from that type of background. So reading the report, it is interesting to see how they have gone through how the process of the budget went and what can be approved, what findings they found on some things that went a little bit awry and some things that worked really well. So one of the findings that I did find quite interesting was the committee's consideration of the 2019-20 budget estimates was not adversely affected by the transcription errors in the budget papers. So again, learning in my own committees around grammar and getting things slightly wrong in a committee report, I could only imagine when it's to do with numbers how easy it is to get something slightly wrong and then it become quite a big issue, potentially being raised in the House and so on and so forth. So going through the report, I did notice, as the Honourable Martin Pritchard alluded to, in Appendix 1, the summary of agency hearings, it was quite interesting to read and get a bit of a flashback at what was a great program in the Kimberleys. The Earbus program was a three-year grant program and was subject to a formal evaluation. The Earbus program is amazing. You know, there is such massive health issues, particularly out in regional Western Australia, and unfortunately in a very high rate in Indigenous kids. Ear infections can go on to create massive ramifications to a young child's learning ability and also their ability to get through the ear infection can be quite hard. So that program was great to see that was funded through that, and also the dialysis services in the Kimberley as well. Again, another very important health thing that we need in the regions, and again in the Kimberley region as well. There were, by the looks of it in this report, many agency hearings, and I could only imagine how that would have gone for the committee, going through this whole process and having to find out basically from each agency where the money's been spent and how it's been spent. I think particularly in public transport, there were many hearings as well, again, around the rail corridors. You also had the Trans-Geraldton bus services. I'm sure the Honourable Darren West could tell us how great that bus service is. Always on time? Well, that's good. I'd like to say the ones in Kalgoorlie are exactly the same, always on time. also, there was meetings with, on the 18th of June in 2019, the Department of Primary Industry and Regional Development. Some of the key things were key performance indicators. The department is working to develop soil carbon, soil health and water retention. Water is a massive discussion at the moment, particularly out in the Goldfields region. And I'm sure the DPIRB are doing a very good job in trying to find new innovative ways to use our waters, because more industry that comes out there, the more amount of water output we actually need to have. And if we don't, we're limiting ourselves on our ability to bring out new investors and our ability to start new projects, which, as everyone knows, in this current economic climate is very important. There are massive projects coming on very soon, actually, Linus being one of them, which is about $500 million worth of investment. And I'm led to believe that, you know, a gigalitre of water is potentially what they need straight off the bat. Now, that's quite an amount of water. So there's also discussions with Fitzroy River Management Plan, capability review of the department, funding and staffing for regional development commissions. Massive thing. I think working closely with regional development commissions for local shires has been important, and the role they're playing in further economic development is massive in regional Western Australia. And I think the local content officers being put back out into the regions has been widely accepted as a positive to the regions, and having them located in the region rather than in Perth, for example, has been very, very well received, particularly by shires in the goldfields. Then local content officers are critical to ensuring that we have as much local content as we can on our projects. Reading the conclusion from the committee report, the committee is satisfied with its thematic approach to this year's budget estimates. The subject matter of SPAs was thoroughly canvassed. The evidence provided to the committee indicates that agencies are managing SPAs appropriately and are audited regularly. Further, the committee also highlighted the relationship between spending from SPAs and the impact on the broader whole of government financial accounts. So it is good to see that the process is working well, as per the report. The committee considers that its process for examining the estimates of expenditure are sound. These processes contributed to the scrutiny of the appropriation bills, which received royal assent on the 15th of August 2019. I'm looking forward to the estimates again this year. As I said earlier in my contribution, it has been a learning experience to see how the departments come into this chamber, sit with the minister, and you have the opportunity to ask questions around the budget process directly to the departments through the minister, obviously. But that to me has been pretty interesting. And then I do remember the first day that I got given the budget, I was quite excited, thinking it was going to be this yee-haw moment, and then I got these three volumes of books and went, oh my God, how am I supposed to get through that? And so to see the committee be able to work through that constantly each year and find better ways and processes for us as members to be able to extract more out of the time we have in estimate hearings, I think is something we should applaud the committee for, absolutely. They did have one recommendation that came out of the report, which was on page 14. The Treasurer released a cogitum to correct any known errors in the budget papers, which to me was interesting to see that there was only one recommendation. But the finding that followed before the recommendation, the committee, which I touched on earlier, obviously led through into the recommendation. So not adversely affected by the transcript errors in the budget papers, but that obviously went into another recommendation. Number two, the Treasurer released the condonum to correct any known errors in the budget papers. So that was good to see. It's a good report, and I look forward to hearing other members' contributions. Thank you.